cool. But again, yesterday I checked the 3news.com and I'll check it out shortly for you to see that the Electoral Commission's website, some 10 months or so to the main election, or less than 10 months to the major election, like the December 7 election, where all the stakes are high, we paid over $100,000. If you're multiplying by five, that's about 500,000 Ghana cedis for a website. Half a billion Ghana cedis for a website. And the website is not functional.
It's not functional. I think we did an exclusive on this here at TV3. It hasn't been functional for the past 2 months.
Yeah.
We've been following for the past 2 months.
Well, we've been following.
And it hasn't been functional.
We've been following for the past 2 months. But some other observers tell us that ever since Dr. Jean Mensah took over at the Electoral Commission, the website has not been functional. So if you doubt it now, you'd go to www.ec.gov.gh. Go on to that website right now. You have a smartphone, you have a laptop, you have an iPad, whatever it is. Go on there, www.ec.gov.gh, and check out what we're telling you. You would find that it tells you the bandwidth has been exceeded.
Exceeded, yeah.
Now, the explanation we're getting for
from
what
IT
that,
experts,
for that
yeah.
means, Kwame yeah. Owusu and Sam, yeah. who works here,
right.
Tech,
yeah.
IT and Innovation Manager at MG Digital, is that it means that the quantum of resources that was allocated to the website has been used up. Now, the question is, if we're spending over 500,000 Ghana cedis, okay, or $100,000 in excess of that for a website that was contracted under Madame Charlotte, who was then Electoral Commissioner, who was found guilty of breaching procurement procedures by the Chief Justice's Commission, which was one of the reasons she was kicked out of the Electoral Commission.
Yeah, I remember.
How come we still have that website? I mean, 3news.com didn't cost us $100,000.
No.
But our bandwidth is still there. I'm not sure, maybe Ghana Web's website costs $100,000. I'm not sure. More than Ghana. I'm not sure. So I'm thinking, what exactly is happening?
What is happening? We have 10 months to elections. The website must be functional because, you see, when results are declared or whatever information you need with regards to the upcoming elections, you would need to go to the website for verification.
Absolutely.
And so if it is down, there's a problem.
And you know that the lawyer Martin Pebu wrote on behalf of MP for Sherman, Ernest Nogbe, requesting for some procurement documents regarding this new biometric voter registration that and all of that. Imani Ghana or Imani Africa has also been raising concerns. It calls it a sham. It says it is a wham and all of that, because the Electoral Commission is saying that if you want to retrofit the old system that we have, it will cost us about $74 million. But if you want to create a new one, it will cost us $56 million. Imani says that's a complete fallacy, because if you put the figures together, we're actually going to pay some $150 million. All these, you know, I say this, you say that, I say that, you say this, give me documents flatly denied in spite of the RTI being enforced. If the Electoral Commission had a website running, they perhaps would have all these details on. And we could just go and check. So as of now, I don't think there are many Ghanaians who even know who the commissioners of the Electoral Commission are, who the chairperson is, perhaps we know because we've been mentioning, we know who Mr. Tete is, we know who Dr. Bosman Asari is, but who are the others? A lot of people don't know who's the head of IT or the Electoral Commission, who knows who is this. So it is important. And to raise a lot of trust for the Electoral Commission, It needs to be open. So people can have access to it.
And we are in a highly digital, system. You know, everyone relies on the internet to access information.
Right.
And so if the key tool, which is a website for a whole Electoral Commission, is down, it's a not-not.
And our checks also from here at 3news.com will prove that the contract, because the website was hosted by Dream Oval, was designed by Dream Oval and is hosted by Nita in Ghana. Can you imagine? So the question is, don't we have IT experts in this country, companies that could host or this website?
Well, I mean, whatever it is, it won't be they are contracting some of us. What is important is that we need the website.
You were talking about local content a while ago, a few days ago.
I agree. So I'm saying that we need the website to function.
Well, but if we've paid so much for the website and it's not functional, and our checks have proven that the contract that was given to Dream Oval has been terminated. Mm-hmm. Okay, so who is explaining why it's been terminated? Mm-hmm. Why is the website not functional? Mm-hmm. Especially when the Electoral Commission has a lot of information to give out. Mm-hmm. And the Electoral Commission sometimes will come and say, oh, the media needs to partner with them to help. How do you get information if you don't have? I mean, do I need to always pick a phone and call Sylvia or some district director of elections.
Just to access information, when I can just click and get
click on and go there. Yeah. I mean, it helps even the citizenry, those who want to participate in elections, those who want to follow, observe the elections from all walks of life, people watching from outside Ghana and the rest, to know what the original figures are. Mind you, at some point during the 2016 election, the Electoral Commission said that its website had been hacked. Mm-hmm. So now we're talking firewalls, we're talking the websites running, we're talking, and I am just thinking of the amount of money there. Mind you, this is not to run the Electoral Commission down. This is to say
you have spent
$108,000 on
that
a website
that is not functional.
Why?
And this is the taxpayers' money. We demand some answers.
So, share your thoughts. I'm sure by now you have gone on to check www.ec.gov.gh. That's www.ec.gov.gh. Go and check that website of the Electoral Commission, or you check out the story on 3news.com. Find out all the details, because the Electoral Commission's website, what we're telling you this morning is that it is not functional. So if you want any information, random information about the Electoral Commission, and you thought that you're going to check their website, like you check 3news.com, like you check TV3.network.com, you won't find a website to you'll be hit in the face with a white screen that says bandwidth exceeded.
And I don't know why. I mean, you EC is saying they are embarking on compilation of a new register. They're starting on the 18th of April. They are ending on the 30th of May. And all this information must be on the website.
Absolutely.
You know, so that people will know whether really it is starting, whether discussions are still ongoing, whether the EC is backing down or, you know, on its decision to go on this new compilation of a new register. I don't know, man.
Okay. All right. So join us with your thoughts and comments. You're a Ghana man or a Ghana woman. This should be of great concern to you this morning, especially knowing that the Electoral Commission is supposed to be independent. It's supposed to be an independent arbiter of the forthcoming polls on December 7th. The Electoral Commission is supposed to be neutral, free and fair, and firm as well. We expect that the citizenry are informed, especially with the passage of the Right to Information law. And so good morning to you, Dr. Jean Mensah of the Electoral Commission. Good morning to you, Dr. Bosman Asari of the Electoral Commission. Good morning to you, Mr. Tete of the Electoral Commission. We love you. And Sylviano, we love you. Question, why is the website down? And why are you not responding? You have said nothing about it. And we are worried. So we are asking the questions. Good morning to you.